this film will look into the research carried out to prove that audiences actively watch talent shows, using Pop Idol and X Factor as my text examples, just to be entertained by contestants' humiliation and to watch nobodies become stars. It will look into three theories, the uses and gratification theory, star theory, and cultivation theory, and will link them to my two chosen texts from different eras.
In other words, it's not really looking at the question of how the mass media affects us, more how the audience reacts to the mass media. It assumes that the audience chooses the media it wants to watch for different reasons.
Similar shows to those that I'm looking at include New Faces from 1973, Opportunity Knocks from 1956, and Stars in Their Eyes from the 90s.
Customers, this is your Opportunity Knocks All Winners Show!
The books that I have read for research include Media Studies, Text Production Context, The Media, An Introduction, The Media Studies Book, and The Cinema Book. Pop Idol started in 2001, when audiences didn't have the access to social media technology available today. This meant audiences had less interaction with television shows than they do nowadays. However, the first Pop Idol received high voting figures despite only having internet and telephone voting. Despite not being able to interact with the show as much, fans could still travel to Madame Tussauds to visit the interactive attraction. Pop Idols aired primetime Saturday nights, meaning that audiences could get together with their family to enjoy the show all together. As audiences didn't have any on-demand services, unless they taped it if they were busy, they would miss out at work Monday morning and wouldn't have anything to talk about with their friends. This links with the integration and social interaction aspect of the uses and gratifications theory, where audiences use a mass media text to go away and talk about it with their friends on what they have viewed the next day.
Next comes integration and social interaction. It's the idea that people take the programmes they see and then chat about them later. Within this section, there's also an idea of imagined community. It's the idea that you might feel like when you're watching something, you're watching it with loads of other people, even if they're not sitting right next to you. Reality TV often tries to heighten this experience with phone-ins or backstage shows.
Pop Idol was controversial, as it was known to humiliate those that just didn't look the part or obviously lacked talent. The judges responded with clear disgust and open laughter. The manager of Take That said that the show was humiliating contestants for the sake of ratings. Therefore, it could be argued that, as the uses and gratifications theory points out, audiences use Pop Idol to escape their lives and laugh at somebody else's misfortune as they humiliate themselves, making audiences feel better about themselves. Pop Idol links to the culture aspect of star theory, as audiences would watch the text because upcoming stars would signify social, ideological and moral values, telling them how to behave, think and look. The show was presented by two already well-loved television stars, Ant and Dec. Audiences would have seen that Ant and Dec were presenting, and that would have enticed them to watch the show more. The cultivation theory by George Berbner reinforces an audience's beliefs and would explain that the longer audiences watch Pop Idol, the more they would have thought that it was okay to judge people this way.
Theorists argue that television has gradual, long-term effects, but they're small and over time, unlike the hypodermic needle model, which doesn't really give any time period. They also argue that these changes aren't actually changes, they just reinforce the norms. Gerbner argued that the people who watch a lot of television are more likely to be influenced. That's hypodermic needle theory. However, cultivation theory is slightly different. Gerbner argued that this happens over time and with lots of television viewing, and argued that it only reinforced that person's opinion rather than changing it. So here's our guy again who really likes oranges. And the media are only reinforcing that opinion that oranges are great. He now really, really likes oranges. Rather than changing his opinion, they've reinforced it.
Fans that want to further their interest in the show can then go out and buy the DVD and CDs of the winners. The X Factor started in 2004, created by Simon Cowell to replace Pop Idol. The similarities between both shows caused a legal dispute between Cowell and Pop Idol creator Simon Fuller. According to Star Theory, This meant that audiences would have watched X Factor because of the scandal they had seen and would have wanted to see the similarities for themselves. Referring to the integration and social interaction aspect of uses and gratifications theory, audiences now have many more ways to get involved with X Factor thanks to the rise in social media. Audiences can now use their mobiles to access Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, etc. in their hands. Voting can now be done through mobile apps. Audiences of X Factor can have conversations with people all over the country, giving them a sense of imagined community, where the audience feels like they are watching a text with other viewers by allowing audiences to download and connect with other viewers in apps and offer a sideshow with extra backstage gossip. This is where fandom evolves. A fandom is created once audiences become more involved with a text. A viewer may contribute to a forum to share an appreciation with others about the text, or go to a social event such as Comic-Con. Audiences use X Factor as a way of escapism, which is another section of the uses and gratifications theory. X Factor is shown primetime weekend evenings, allowing for audiences to get together, unwind and forget about their daily struggles for the night. Linked to the personal identity section of the uses and gratifications theory, audiences can use X Factor to reinforce their personal value and to find models of behaviour, gaining an insight into themselves. This means audiences look up to contestants as role models and start to mimic traits that they identify with. One criticism is that X Factor is desensitising viewers to sexualisation. This links to the cultivation theory and means the more a viewer watches something, the less bothered about it they become. For example, a young girl dressed in a respectful way suddenly becomes a sexual object when it comes to live shows as the producers give the contestants makeovers and a bid to make them look right for the audience. With X Factor, star theory is apparent. Having judges such as Simon Cowell, Louis Walsh and Sharon Osbourne are going to interest the viewers. Audiences are going to want to watch star judges and star presenters. The audience also get an insight into the lives of upcoming stars with sob stories at the beginning of auditions to scandals in the news once they get a taste of fame. Audiences love deviants. In conclusion, although my findings can't be an accurate representation of everybody in the country that watches X Factor and Pop Idol, I think it is clear through my research that there are people that go out of their way to watch these shows just to humiliate people and to feel better about themselves, to escape their lives and to sit down with friends and loved ones and chat about what they have seen the night before at work or at school, all the while making fun of people that are trying to become somebody in the national public eye.
What's the funny, mate?
It's just different to have somebody that was a jockey. I just can't see you riding a horse.
Sorry about that.
Can I just look at the words?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
I knew them when it came in. So tired of broken hearts and losing at this game.
Sorry, I'm going to ask Louis to leave the room. Louis. Sharon, Louis, leave the table, please.
Why?
Because she's trying to sing Madonna. You know what? You two should just go next door and let this girl sing. I'm being serious.
She's not singing.
Go on, off you go. Leave the table.
She's not okay, okay. Oh, God, I couldn't stop. I tried.
Shut up!
Shut up!
Should we just go to the chorus? Because okay. I don't think we're ever going to get there.